Okay. Saturday. No, it's Sunday, March 3rd at 1:22 p.m. Holy shit. It's already 1:22 p.m. I've got this canvas ready to go. It's already nice and tight. It's 16 by 20. And I've got my palette ready to go. I got some splotches of white. I like to have white to mix with different colors because they tend to be very saturated already. And I got my brushes, my short selection brushes over here, and some more brushes just in case I might want over here. And just all over to the left are all my paints. There's like paints over here, here, here. And that's it. So, okay. So I'm going to go throw myself back in there just for the hell of it. Okay, so this today, focus, there we go. Okay, so today I have an idea to make. I'm not sure what's going to be on the bottom. Probably just land again, I guess. But imagine if the clouds, it's kind of like what you'd see. I'm envisioning like something that's like, I've seen at oceans, the sun at oceans when it's behind clouds. You know, like that silver lining. I did a big painting a while ago called Waves Worshipping the Sun or something. And I did the same idea where there's some clouds and then you'll see like rim lighting. And then more subtle rim lighting. So as if the sun is, I don't know why, I like to put the sun right here. For some reason, it feels good putting the sun over here. So this time, I think the sun will maybe barely be poking through the clouds. But imagine, so it's going to be like a dark forefront with almost like fiery, fiery rim lighting. Hey, Cheryl. And then the top, I'm not sure what I'm going to do just yet. Anyhow, let's just get started with underwash. Now let's try that. A touch of red because it's so strong. And how about a touch of darker red? Let's just bring those oranges over here. Let's just try this. Okay, I think I need a bit more paint. The color scheme I'm thinking of is like dark blues and oranges, like bright yellow. So like there's like some sort of clouds, bright yellow, and darker blues down here, and then the sky. I'm not quite sure yet. It could be a hopeful kind of color sky, kind of like that. Was that what I called a Catching the Sun one, where it was very morning, very bright, optimistic? I don't know. Because I'm thinking the bottom part is like intense. Oh, I don't like it. It sounds goofy, but it's almost like you feel the presence of God. Okay, so I'm not religious. I don't at all. But what it's the kind of thing where if you were to see it in real life, you'd be like, wow, this world is incredible. So that's the kind of feeling I want to go for. I don't know why. Who knows? Just go with the flow. Okay. All right, so we got a color down. Very pinkish. And I'm not a fan of pink. Oh, it's a little purpley. Let's try this. That red was very purpley. All right. All right, so don't need this brush now. I'm just going to put it aside. All right. Let's, oh, I should zoom in a bit, should I? Maybe this is more interesting if I zoom in. But yeah, just while it's drying, I actually have a roll of duct tape underneath it, so it's tilted up towards me. And then I've tilted the camera head at a slight angle, so it's more front on. That's just my little setup. Because otherwise you have to sort of, like, you can't really... You can't see properly. In fact, it would be better if I was painting more like this. But this at least, I mean, the difference is there's going to be no real dripping. If I do it vertically, there'll definitely be dripping, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, but I don't know. Okay. Love freedom of expression in colors, no censorship in art. Yeah, pretty much. All right, well, let's see. What's a good... I can't quite see them very well. Okay, this one I've always liked. Even though it's bent. It's like, poor bastards. I don't know, maybe I bit with my teeth. See how it's bent? The metal's bent right there. Some point it's going to snap off, but it's held up so far. Okay, so here we go. The clouds. What color would be good? Let's try this one. Maybe a little. Well, it doesn't really matter. What I do. So, try the. Sort of like that. And then like that. So there's gonna be real dark here. Like that. That might be too dark. Let me just try adding a little bit of light in here. Do you use a particular brand of paint? Yes. I'm using Winsor & Newton Artisan Water Mixable Oil Paints. There's a little bit of white. Cerulean blue. I like my cerulean blue. Is that cerulean blue? A little bit. The sky. What's the sky gonna be? What's on the ground? This is still sky, right? You have a special coffee today, yeah? That's kind of weird. You know, people notice that. Ah, you're making freaking me out. Did I just bump the camera? What about, okay. What's on the ground? I don't know what's on the ground, but I want to go right to the light. There's something about this light I need to do. Sound effects add to the creativity art. Yeah, I can't help it. It just gets me in the mood. It feels wrong not to have sound effects. Damn it, come on, just wash. Fuck, I don't need this. Okay. What color would be good? What should I do? Yeah, I think maybe I should do the under, like the sky color first. Thinking, yeah, maybe it's like a blue green. I wonder if I just take this yellow and just start mixing it in. It's gonna create with the red that's there, it's gonna do something. That's my expectation. I want it to be greenish, bluish green. So maybe if I just tap that, yeah, that's kind of what I'm going for. Just tap it. It's too blue, so let's just mix it on the canvas. No, it's too dark. Let's white some white. Oh, excuse me. I should use a big brush for this. Get my handy watercolor brush. Yeah, I just gotta lay down a foundation here. Needs a foundation of something. Let's do blues, some yellows, some whites. Let's just get like a foundation. In fact, maybe I'll try leaving some of this like a red show through. That might be kind of neat. White, some more yellow. And some, yeah, the blue. Where's the blue? This blue? Oh, that's too much blue. Ooh, that's quite an intense green. Why not? I think the green with the red, it's funky. It's funky. And then I gotta... maybe more oranges on this side and yellows on this side. How about that? Or would it be more yellows? I can't even see that orange because it's so close to that background color. Cerulean blue, yellow, mixed, white. Whoa. What am I going to do with the ground? Okay, I should probably start thinking about the ground here. How long does it take to complete the average size painting? Well, these are pretty small for me. This is a 16 by 20. Normally I like working on large pieces that are like 4 by 6, 4 by 7. I would say for the small ones, I've been just like an hour is if I've been leaving them raw. And then when I get more finitic-y, I just made up that word. I've noticed I can only paint for an hour at a time. I get completely drained out. So like that stupid painting I did, this one here. Well, it's not worth showing. It took me 7 painting sessions and I'm still not happy with it. And each one was about an hour and a half. So that one took like, 8 hours, but over a week period. It really depends. It's all about like I got like that sort of limited creative juices, and when I work at like it gets sucked out, and I got to stop and take a break. I definitely can since I started doing this live stream painting. I can't paint for long periods of time. It just sucks too much energy because I'm aware that people are watching, and I'm kind of like. To be honest, I don't like it. It makes me uncomfortable, and I feel I have to perform, and I can't really be myself. I can't really relax. But when I'm painting by myself and there's no one around, I'll have music playing. I'll probably, I'll randomly swear. Like I swear like here all the time, but I can go for 8-10 hours, no problem. Like all I need is like not to have any commitments. So literally, if I have to make a business call, my whole day is ruined. I just can't get into painting. So it's like I have to like seize the moment kind of thing. Just life always gets in the way, you know what I mean? Okay. This is what's going to be cool. Once we get to a little bit later, I'm going to put this, imagine like intense fire, like edge along here. It's just going to... it's gonna be fucking dramatic. That's all. Just trust me. I know what I'm doing. The only thing I gotta figure out right now is what the hell to do about the bottom. What's gonna be on the bottom? Please don't give me any suggestions because I'm so stubborn. Even if someone is being completely helpful, as soon as they make a suggestion, it ruins it for me. I'll have to turn off the chat because I don't want to be influenced. It's so ridiculous. Wait, oh, there's a whole bunch of text. Interrupts your focus. Yeah. I mean, I like talking to people. Don't get me wrong. I like it. But when I'm in my kind of like art mode where I have to tap into something that's not even me, the decisions just come out. I don't need any help. In fact, I don't want help. It's worse. When someone says, oh, add yellow here, honestly, it's just like someone went, grabbed my face and punched it, and I'm like, ah, fuck off. And I don't like being rude to people. Sometimes it just overcomes me. Like I'm like, ah, I know what I'm doing. Like, I'm what's it called? It's like a rhetorical question. I'm asking myself something, and I have to solve it myself. I can't take any suggestions. It ruins it for me. It takes it away. All right. So enough of that stupid rambling. It's really best if I don't say anything ever. I'm such an idiot. Okay. All right. I'm not quite feeling it yet. I'm feeling it soon. It's coming. It's coming. I can feel it coming. The power is coming soon now. What do I do? Do I do a bit of land at the bottom? What are you going to be? What are you going to become? You're going to become something. I know what I might do. Okay, I could do this. Here's an idea. No one say anything. I'm going to have to close the chat because I know I'm going to fuck it up. Oh, there's a whole bunch of text. Just happy to watch. Oh, so you understand. Go, man, go. Hey, Wesley. All right, so I'm thinking maybe doing... Oh, fuck, do I do water? wonder how it's gonna look. Okay, I'm thinking there's a, maybe it's a Tom Thompson painting, and I can see it in my mind very clearly. And what he did is he used large strokes, and then they became little as he went towards the water here. I might do that, but I don't know if it would work with this right now. I don't know if it would work with this. I don't know. All right, let's go have some. This is going to be the fun part. This is going to be the fun part. Okay, get ready for this. Do I do this orange? This orange could be work with that orange. Or maybe this orange. Let's just see what happens if I take both. Okay. Let's just try this. No, it needs to be brighter. It needs yellow. It needs to be brighter. I'm going to do a bunch of layers on this. The problem is I'm going to keep my brush clean. Watch this. Maybe this yellow, orange. That needs to be lighter. Let's try putting white to this orange. It has to be a transition from one, like if this is going to be more orange and this is going to be more green. So maybe I'll put yellows with the green. I don't want it to be smooth. It can't be smooth. It's got to be like clouds are at their tips are very. Oh shit, sexy peach. Love the sound. Inspiring. Okay, good. No one's made any suggestions. Thank you. I left those spots here for this. Actually, I even need white. Okay, here's where it's gonna get so intense. I need the white. How would I do this? I gotta think about this for a second. If the light's coming this way, are they gonna hit the edges of the clouds? And also too, like maybe. Think about like some flow here. It's like really, sometimes it's just so draining, man. Gotta think about like how do like I wanted the light to come through the clouds. God damn it, it's not working. Something's not working. Think. It's got to be like photoluminescence. I don't know if even know what the word would be called, like where want there to be as if the light is coming through and it's hitting these like clouds, and there's got to be like maybe I'll look at maybe I'll bloop bloop bleep bloop bloop bloop, bloop. Maybe make the color. Maybe there are like little clouds, like something like that. But maybe at the top, I kind of want it to be simpler at the top. Then this is too purple at the bottom. I want to bring it down to blue. What color is this? That's exactly the color I want. This is it. Yes! That's what I want. Where have you been, color? I was looking for you. I was waiting for you. And now you are here. Do I make it go? Yeah, why not? Not sure. Like how, oops, like where would the darkest part of a cloud be? Up here, but there's got to be something down here. And what are you going to be at the bottom? What are you going to be at the bottom? I got to blow my nose. I got to have a drink. I got to just, let's see, look it on the screen. It is so helpful. In fact, one of the reasons why I haven't been painting on the big painting on the big up there is I love sitting down, and also I love being able to see my painting on the screen because it's totally flat. Here I'm at a, I'm at a, where's the camera? I'm at a serious angle looking at this picture, and I get glow from the screen, so it's kind of like what you see is not what I see. I see something here. I'll show you what I see. I see something like, oh, how does it look? I see something like that. And my brain interprets it and makes it flat. That's okay, but it's really nice. So you know what I might do? I have an idea. What if I took up a computer monitor and I hung it on the wall, and then I would use that when I'm standing up? That's a cool idea. I've been actually thinking about smashing down this like separation over here. Because of the space I have for my big paintings, we got a whole bunch of some stored there, and it's about 8 feet across. But there's a big like hall closet. I think I just might fucking smash it down so I can have more space. Okay, it is super safari. Love oils can change so much with one stroke. Yep, much different indeed. Looks like 3D. Ciao, bello. What? When are you speaking Italian? All right. I don't know. I don't know. Okay. The whole bottom. Yeah, fuck it. Let's just try that thing I was talking about before. Let's just try that and see how it works. What colors here? No. All right. Well, screw it. Let's just put some of these pink colors down. Let's try doing. Actually, this brush might work. A little bit, not spongy enough for me. I want this square. Oops, this square one is better. So check it out. I don't know if you can see this. Where's the camera? This one, they're both thin and flat. But this one, the brushes are very strong and thick. And this one, there's a bit more flex to it. And that's what I want. I want a bit more flex. It'll paint, pick up the paint better. Because I want to do these light brush strokes. Let's just do a couple. Now, mind you, the colors, I'm just putting down some straight colors here. Probably will change. This is kind of what I was thinking about at Tom Thompson painting. I can't remember which one it is, but I can see it really clearly. So, and I'm just doing things. And then, like maybe even browns. The idea is they're going to get thinner. I'll need another brush to do the thinner stuff. I should use this paint, this color. And I might. Oh wait, am I not doing land? Yeah, so I haven't decided if I'm going to do land. If this is straight water, I got to treat it differently. It could be straight water. This old house? The hell does that mean, this old house? Was that a TV show? I'm going to look it up. I'm just stalling right now. I'm going to look up this old house. I think, is that that? Oh yeah, is that old TV show where they used to smash it down to renovations? Yeah. This old house, home improvement and remodeling. Oh, I remember that guy. I loved home renovation shows. I like the one with the guy in Toronto. What that guy's name? He's like the big guy and he's got like short blonde hair. And he's always very particular, like, you know, to do it right. And he had this sidekick dude who lives around the corner from me. What's that show called? Home Renovation House. And I think the show is the guy's name. Someone's got to know it. So it's a Canadian show. God, what's that guy's name? He's like Mr. Clean, but with hair. And I've seen it at the Home Depot by where I live, because I love Home Depot. I could just walk around Home Depot for hours. What the hell is that guy's name? Come on, Sheila, you know, you're from Toronto. John? Is it John? I gotta look it up. TORON Toronto Home Improvement TV Show. What's that guy's name? Mike Holmes. That's it. Mike Holmes. And Mike Holmes, you ever watch that show? I loved it. I loved it when they destroy things. Because I actually renovated my home basement. Brian Bulmer or the Make It Right guy. No, it was Mike Holmes. I don't know if you're in the States, you probably won't know him. And it's just so cool because I renovated my basement myself. It took me 6 months. This was after working my ass off for like, I don't even know, about 2 decades in the video game industry. I worked my ass off. And I finally said, screw it, I need a break. This was before my son was born. And I renovated the whole basement. I single-handedly pulled off the whole basement floor. I started off with the corner because I thought part of the floor was a little wonky. So I had a sledgehammer, smashed it down to the sand. And I'd be, oh, I gotta do more. So I took some of the, like, it was like 180 bags of concrete I hand carried outside to my backyard and re-poured the whole basement floor. I had help from this old dude who lived around the corner. He was a Vietnam vet And he was basically just a general contractor dude who helped me with stuff I didn't know. So, like, you know, I didn't trust myself enough to do electrical or plumbing, but I learned a shit ton about plumbing. So we did all the plumbing by hand and replaced the whole floor. I did most of the drywall. I did all the destruction. That was, I would, like, don't recommend renovating a basement. The ceiling, you know, my house is like 119. It was probably renovated in the 70s, but it's 1920, I think, was made. But it was just gross. All that 50 years of dust and stuff build up in the ceiling. And I did a good job, like Brian, but I loved it, man. I loved just doing that work. No, all day long, just sweating, you know. And I cared well. Like, I did, we did custom cabinetry. I put in a bathroom. I soundproofed the whole thing. So I was at Home Depot around the corner, like, every day. That was a good 6 months. I loved it. Rebuilt the stairs. I built this cool custom cabinet, so it takes space. Okay, right now I just gotta say my tinnitus is really, really, really loud, and I just gotta keep on talking. So the reason why I'm rambling right now is because this talking helps distract me. Otherwise, I'll start crying like a baby. So I'm just gonna keep on talking. Renovating basement. Yes, renovating basement. I spent a long time doing that. Custom cabinetry. Actually, the only thing I didn't do was the carpeting. There's a carpeting place not far from me, and I was so exhausted. I knew how to do carpeting, but I'm not good at cutting straight lines, and you do need a couple special tools if you want to do it well. And I just, you know, it's not a big basement or anything, so I hired them to come in, and they were done in like 4 hours. They did the stairs in like, honestly, it must have been like 2 hours, and it would have taken me all day. And what they do, like, they, you know, you have to be able to pull it tight. So you put the baseboard, you put this little thin strip that has metal, a little, like, nails basically sticking up all along the edges. And that's what's used to attach. But you have to, like, use this sort of, like, vice grip thing to pull everything tight. And you also, the other thing I highly recommend is spend extra, if you do a basement, spend extra on the anti-moisture padding underneath. Go for the thicker one. It's more expensive, but the last thing you want to have is we don't want mold. So they actually have this padding material that goes under your carpet that can prevent moisture buildup. And so that was worthwhile. So now in my basement, you could jump around everywhere and stuff. But it's not so great when you get a dog because there's this freaking hair everywhere in every cranny. Okay, so I'm not so sure I like this thing, this stuff I've been doing here. I mean, I'm going to go and I'm going to start playing with the colors and make them thinner. And then I can decide whether I like it or not. This is going to be a lot more dramatic. And I would probably bring the reflections, like the light. Like I'd bring the colors from up there down here. Hopefully. And so what I'm going to do is I'll do thinner horizontal brushstrokes this way. And go, and I like to have, like you see the patterns. Okay, I'm just really, it's so loud. Sorry, I'm a little bit, holy shit, it's just like so loud. Fucking, it's not fun. Oh, you son of a bitch. I have to take a break for 1 second. It's just... When I do this, I found that if I stick my finger in my ear and I pop it out, for 2 seconds I get a break. 2 seconds. And then it's back to the screaming. I think that's probably saved my life, is knowing that I could have a break for 2 seconds. Okay. I did ceramic tile in my kitchen and hall, matching backsplash for broken tile. Yeah, where did I do? Oh, yeah, my first house in the kitchen floor, I worked on the ceramic tile and I hated it. I fucked it up big time. You know, you really got to do it right. With ceramic tile, the most important thing is a flat subfloor. So you have to remove everything. You have to go down to the base plywood. Most houses have base plywood. And then you have to make it level. Not just for like true level, but also level for the edges, which let's say they're appliances or counters. So you that's a work of like that's something I didn't do a good job on, because if you don't have a very very true flat surface, the tiles will crack eventually. Starts to whisper if she's too loud. I don't know what that means. But I thought. Yeah, so I did. I thought I did tiling somewhere else, and I was not a fan. I was too impatient. It required too much planning. Like, I don't like measuring things, and you have to measure things really well. You know, you really need a tile cutter. And how did I do it? Did I cut them by hand, like with just a chipper thing, which requires you to like to constantly like brush off the edges to make them fit? Okay, so this thing, I'm not sure if it's working here. I think this might be too much of a different style. It's still very rudimentary where I am at this painting. Exactly, did it diamond style? Oh yeah. Yeah, there's all kinds of different ways you can do tiling. Yeah, I learned about that too. Like, you can make it kind of complicated. And to be honest, sometimes the complicated, I don't even like how they look. I'm more a fan of a minimalist kind of style. I need to redo the tiles in my bathroom upstairs. They're getting kind of nasty. But yeah, tiling, then you got to deal with grout. I think maybe what I did when I first did the grout, I did the wrong color of grout. I didn't even know there was such a thing. Like, still too purple down here. I don't want it to be that purple. I think this is the blue. Yeah. And also, the thing is, I'm not that well versed on water. I haven't spent enough time observing how it should behave. What I mean is, what am I trying to say? What I'm trying to say is, like, this doesn't feel right at all. It feels goofy. So I'll just start messing with it. Let's just start playing with it. Let's start painting over. See if this does anything. Oh. Definitely better. It's creating all kinds of interesting colors and it feels better. Like the other one was just, it was just the wrong style. It was too pizzicato, too pixelated, too Surratt, too. Surratt was a guy who just was overrated. They just took complementary and juxtaposing dots of color, slapped them all together. Kind of like a Fauvist Alex Colville, who was also, I think, kind of sucked. Stuff was always so dead and dry, just because he did a lot of fucking little dots. never impressed me. God, I'm such a harsh critic. Okay. Okay, so what I want to do is like build up interesting layers of clouds. Okay, this definitely needs a horizon.
Yeah, it just, it looks,
Yes, I've painted with a palette knife a whole bunch of times. And yeah, I've got one somewhere around here. Yeah, it could, the palette knife is nice because it definitely makes different shapes and brushes. Brushes, yeah, and I like that. I like that. In fact, it might actually need some palette knife work to make it less brush stroke like, you know what I mean? Like maybe these things could be more. Like what's missing is that, okay, the intensity thing I was talking about, I haven't done that yet. I still have to bring it in here. It's going to be like maybe this yellow. Yeah, I definitely like this yellow. This is like a beautiful, it's not a lemon yellow. It's more like a, well, it's more like a rich yellow. So I'm going to build this up a bit maybe. I'm not quite sure, like maybe should it come out more like this? All I know is I really want it to like blast out kind of like, and then like, maybe even coming over here, maybe. Oh, this orange. No, wait, this orange? What I want to do is I want to build up a bit of how do I describe it? Like I want there to be still some like cloud texture stuff happening inside this space here, down here. So actually, I think maybe I'll make it like if there's a horizon, if I'm doing water, it's probably lighter along the bottom. I don't know. And I want it to be like, so here I need some work. I need to just let my fingers do the walking and just create something. Yeah, I know what I'm doing wrong. I need to make it so that lightness in the middle, orange, and then, yeah. Watch. Take a fine brush. Check this out. I'm going to get some, what color would be a good orange? Probably this one or this one. With this one, and it's gonna be like a surround where the light comes through. Let's just say if the light was coming through here, the problem is my paint is still so thick, it's like behaving a little annoyingly. So come on, it's picking up the dark brown quite a lot. But let me do this. Yellow, Need more yellow white. This may not be the right color, but it would go in. No, it's not bright enough. Like, it's gonna have to be inside. Like inside here. What if there's like a bit of, yeah, like what if there's like a bit of. It's not quite right yet. I need to, it's too smooth. I need to. Yeah, so maybe I'll make this part really stand out. I just have to hold my breath when I do this. Oh, there's a bunch of text. Cool, I love the texture. I'd love to know how to do paint surf and animal fur. Looks cool. Amazing how different it looks when I tilt my laptop screen, yeah? Don't let the sun go down on me. Don't let the sun dun, dun, da, 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 da. I wanna bring in the green. Here comes the green. I need some green. Where is the green? Here's green. All right, I kind of feel like taking a break. It's just simply because I just feel a little bit tired. Ugh. I bet you it's close to an hour. That's probably what happens. It's just weird, like clockwork for me. I don't even have to look. I just know it's almost an hour. The sun go down on me. Don't let the sun da 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 da. Losing everything is like the sun going down on me. Not happy with the bottom. Not happy with the bottom at all. Still needs a whole bunch of work. Yeah, still needs a bunch of work. It's definitely not there yet. It has no flow. It's not having these. Yeah, there's no flow yet. The problem is the bottom really sucks. I did this. If I did that, like just sort of have like two spits of land here, and then I could do that kind of reflection thing I like to do. Oh, do I even have green? Well, I just want to cheat right now. I'm gonna just cheat with some green. Oh, look at the oil coming out of that. Let's just put green here. Can't even tell it's green. Let's just try this for a second. And I'll do a reflection, but maybe I'll make the reflection this time narrower. And then this will be a sky. Then we'll take one more brush. Let's try it. Now it's too strong. This one? That might work. Okay, let's just try and grab some of this, and then this could be the sky. Don't let the sun go down on me. Don't let the sun dun dun da 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 da. Where's the green? I just had green. Maybe, I didn't put it on the table, on the thing. Maybe I need a light blue, because actually light blue is like atmospheric perspective. So I gotta figure out how it's going to look. And this one will be a little bit more. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to just take a break for a while. Just something. It's like my eyes are hurting. Maybe that's too blue. I gotta think about this a bit more. Something just isn't quite being pulled off that I need. Yikes. That's too muddy. I wanted a bit of muddy, but that's too muddy. Yeah, it's too muddy. I do like that mustard. Nope, too muddy. Mustard's okay. I'll go with mustard. It needs to be livened up a bit. Lively up yourself. Don't be no drag. Lively up yourself. Because reggae is not bad. Lively up yourself, because I said so. Lively up yourself. Blah, 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 blah. Lively up yourself, because Rick is not bad. Lively up yourself, because I said so. Needs to be like a needs some more rhythm, so like needs like a something like that where it's just carrying the light across. Like you can't just die here. I gotta this whole thing needs work. Whatever this thing is. Oops, I didn't want to do that.
Is that green?
Needs more flow. So this will be more, maybe I'll make this section more orange, and then this section will be more, sorry, no, this section will be more orange. And then this will be more yellow and white. I don't know why, just fuck it, because what if I did like now. Well, that looks terrible. Oh, for fuck's sake. It's not doing what I want it to do. This color, I gotta kill. I gotta kill all that. That is just not good. Is this the blue I liked? Yeah. It's not what I wanted. Not what I wanted. It's too blue. It's too blue. I want more muted. How do I mute you? I'm gonna add some gross colors in there. Blech. Okay. I don't know. Losing everything. I just changed it. Oh, I don't like how bright this intense color is. This is too happy, saturated. So let's darken it down. It needs to be defabulicized. Let's bring some brown in there. Muddy it up a bit. There we go. That's a bit better. It's just too damn happy, that brown. Let's just throw some umber in there. Blech. There we go. There we go. Throw some white in there just to see. Yeah, it's a little bit less. Losing everything. This painting sucks. Totally sucks. It sucks. Da 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 da. Not happy with it at all. What if I did something weird, like just put light down here, so we don't even know if this is water, or we just don't know what this is. It could be water. Okay. Actually, I like that a little bit better. Now, I'm going to have to come back and then just play with this light. It is not doing what I want it to do. I need it to be better. I need a thin brush. Painting live is a stress maker. Have fun and don't mind us. Things will set themselves in motion. Yep. Looks like a slight miss, right? Do you ever use your fingers tissue? Yeah, I've been using my fingers quite a bit. Oh my God, Cheryl. I'm not adding gray. God damn it. God damn it, woman. I don't do requests, ever. In fact, you can always trick me with reverse psychology, Cheryl. All you have to do is say, don't put grays in there. And I'll be like, fuck you, I'm putting grays in. I'm going to put so much gray in there. See, that's how I operate. I do not listen to anyone's authority, ever. Never have, never will. That's my tip of the day, Cheryl. I will absolutely do the opposite of what anybody says I should do. I make myself laugh. It's funny. It's like I'm a child. But I just can't help it. That's just the way I am. Oh, more comments. My, you're a Krabby Parker? The fuck is a Krabby Parker? That's like some reference. I have no idea what that means. I think you just made that up, didn't you? You just made up some weird ass reference. Krabby Parker? Does he make sense? The fuck is a Krabby Parker? I'm crabby, all right, that's for sure. See, what it is, I was destined to be a grumpy old man. I'm looking forward to being a grumpy old man and complaining, get off my lawn. I love it. I love it. Quit your yapping. See, I'm good at that. I love it. I love grumpy old men. They're the best. Because you know they're always honest. They don't give a shit either. That's my... When I've reached ascendance, when people try to like become enlightened, the moment of enlightening me is when I'm completely embraced not giving a shit what anybody thinks. And I'm just grumpy and... It's just always complaining. What do you know? Get the hell. I do that with my best friend all the time. It's funny. See, things, once people know me, they know I'm joking 99% of the time, and I do not take things personally. Like, you could insult the hell out of me as much as you wanted, but... Yeah, I just have fun with it. So here's what's wrong. What's wrong is there's got to be like the light is just not good right here. I haven't captured that light that I'm trying to get at. And I'm not quite sure. Like, I imagine there might be. Hmm. Maybe that's the key, is I juxtapose some orange around here. And go in later after with that. I gotta sort of like figure out what these brush strokes are like. I'm babbling. Should it come across here? Like, should there be like a... So this, the thing I want the most is turning out the least good, which is this. Maybe I should make the cloud come up more. Maybe it should be more like bursting through up here. Maybe that's what's missing. Maybe it needs to be up here. And then like that, taking over a bit more of the space. Maybe it should be darker too. Oops, wrong color. Losing everything, it's like the sun going down on me. Ba 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 ba. I like to repeat myself a lot when I sing, because I don't know the lyrics, but I still like the songs. So I keep singing, and it'll piss you off, tough shit. Da 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 da. I'm gonna piss you off, tough shit. I'm on my way to be a grumpy old man. I'm on my way. Pretty soon I'll say, get off my lawn. Dun 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 dun. Get off my lawn before I set my golden retriever on you. She will proceed to lick your face. Duh. My golden retriever will lick your face. Duh, nah, nah. You'll get slobber all over you. Dun 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 dun. Slobber on your face. Duh, 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 that's what'll happen to you. Bum, bum, bum. Slobber on your face. You'll get the slobber all over your face. Bum, 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 bum. There's nothing you can do. Ha 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 ha. Dun 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Slob on your face for my golden retriever. And there's dun, 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 dun. Maybe a little bit of different clouds just breaking free. like that. Why not? Maybe over here too. Maybe just a little bit of Van Gogh love over here. Don't want to make it too obvious though. Oops, that's wrong. Don't let the sun go down on me, although I search myself, it's someone else I see. By losing everything, it's like the sun going down on me. I did not know those words. Thank you, Cheryl, for filling in the lyrics. Da 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 on me. Still something isn't right. It's getting slightly better. I'm not quite sure. Don't tell me what I need to figure out on my own. I don't need any help, so get the fuck away. Quit your chirps. Quit your yapping. Da, 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 da. Don't even start with me or I'll have to be even more obnoxious. Okay, well, I don't know what we got here. I got something. It's something I'm not quite ready to give up. Not quite ready to say, to call it quits. It's missing the glow that I wanted, the godly glow. What time is it? I predict we're about an hour and a half. What time is it? It's around here somewhere. Where's the minute? An hour and 22 minutes. That's not bad. Okay, yellow and white. Is that, might be a little too white. Don't get muddy, please. Maybe more white. See, look, it's getting muddy quickly. Ah, don't get muddy. Damn it. To make that really intense. Still not right. Looks kind of stupid to me, actually. It's beginning to piss me off quite a bit. This is not doing what I want it to do. Maybe I should just walk away for a while. To take a break, but definitely am not finished this painting. It's just not there. needs God's hand to come out and say, "Here I am." See, even that's still too. It's just not the right color I want. I want God's hand to come out and punch you in the face. Da, 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 da. Metaphorically. Punch you in the face. Metaphorically. And it isn't punching anyone right now. It's kind of sucky. Yeah, I think it'll benefit if I leave this one for a while. Because I need, the paint is not sticking. It's not sticking the way I need it to. So, what I think is I will leave it for just a little while. Yeah. Okay. Nah, there's something just, it's just I'm not feeling it. It's just not. I think I've been trying too hard to get that thing glowing around this cloud, and it's just looking crap. Okay, well, I'm just going to stop. Anyhow. Yeah. I will see you later. Thanks for watching. Yeah, needs more work. I'm going to come back to it later. So have a great Sunday afternoon.